this is just a principle of the DC machine. So DC machines are composed of a generator and a motor. So both the generator and motors are the similar construction. For the generator actually, we utilize the Fleming's right hand rule. So this is a magnetic field direction is a first finger, and turn direction is a moment. So the quantized moment, quantized move in the influence of the magnetic field, the current produced, the current direction is indicated by the middle finger. So therefore, this is the generator here. So this is not going to stop magnetic field flowing, and this one is the arrow direction, the moment. So the current direction, you see the dot and cross. Dots mean that the current flowing towards you. So this is the, and cross is the current flowing away from you. So this direction with the dot and cross direction with the current direction. So this current direction is also the induced voltage direction. So the E and F is the induced in the quantada. When the quantada in such a direction, related to a magnetic field, that the quantada casts a magnetic field. So that when the quantada is moving under the magnetic field, the induced current and voltage are generated. So this is the generator action. Another one with the motor action. So for the motor action, we are utilizing the Fleming's left hand rule. So first finger direction is the magnetic field, and middle finger direction is the current. When the current moving under the influence of the magnetic field, quantada will be moving. So moving is indicated by the turn direction. So this is the motor. So the north pole to south pole is the magnetic field direction, and the current flowing here is the dot and cross. So the quantada will be moving across in the arrow direction. So the motor action is based upon the fact that a magnetic field is exerted on a current carrying quantada in a magnetic field. So that when the current carrying quantada, so under the magnetic field, the quantada is moving across into the damp direction. So this is for the DC machine basic principle. This is the north pole and south pole. This is the quantada. So quantada are connected to the commutator. So commutator is a segment, and then from the commutator segment that we connected to the branch and connected to the external load. So the voltage are induced in the quantada can be calculated by this formula. E is equal to PLV. So E is a induced voltage. B is a density of the magnetic flux. A is the length of the quantada, and the V is the velocity of the moment. So when there's a current move producing, so in this case the power can be calculated. Power is P is equal to PLV multiplied I. So the DC machine got the two components, your main pole, inter pole, armature, core, commutator, brush holder, and rocker arm. So we can call it the DC machine. So shunt connection. So this is the armature RE and the shunt field RSH are connected in parallel. Okay, armature RE and series field RSE are connected in series, then with the series connection. So this is the shunt connection, armature and shunt field are connected in parallel. And this is the armature and series field are connected in series, so series connection. So this is the squarely excited. So this is the armature winding and field winding are not electrically connected. So field is separately supplied by the external source. So that is the spray excited generator. And this is the Longshan compound. So Longshan compound generator, it consists of the armature CDV and shunt field. So firstly, armature and CDV are connected in CD. The whole combination is connected in parallel with the shunt field. So this is the Longshan compound. And another one is the Shoshan compound. Shoshan compound means that firstly, armature and shunt field are connected in parallel fast, and the whole combination is connected in CD with the CDV. So that will be the Shoshan compound. So this is the Shoshan compound, is the RSE connected in series with the whole combination of the RA and RSH.